Doma Sports Talk Worldwide with some news from the world of boxing. So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed. Now, let's talk a little bit of heavyweight champion WBC style Deontay Wilder about to fight Luis Ortiz soon in a fight that I don't think should happen. Right? Because he shouldn't be fighting Luis Ortiz again. Deontay Wilder, who I consider to be a hero of boxing, and that's any boxer, right? Just not stop at Deontay Wilder. Any boxer that's undisputed or trying to be. So when I'm calling heroes, I'm talking to Terrence Crawfords of the world, right? Becoming undisputed at 140 pounds. I'm talking Julius Ndongo, who tried to become undisputed at 140 pounds, but lost to Crawford after beating Troyanowski in Russia and beating Ricky Burns in Scotland somewhere, right? Then he tried to go to Nebraska to become undisputed by beating Terrence Crawford. It didn't happen, but look what he tried to do. He wasn't even trying to fight at home. Hero, both of them, Crawford and Ndongo. Alexander Usyk, undisputed champion, cruiserweight champion. Beat everybody away from home. Didn't even go home, ever. He don't even know the way home no more. Somebody better get him to GPS. He don't know what time it is. Never goes home and wins those fights. Hero, Mikey Garcia, hero in my opinion. Beating everybody up in all those divisions. Had a little a time he had to take off because people were trying to take too much money from him. Come back, beat up everybody. Then tries to go way up in two weight divisions to fight Errol Spence when others weren't. Still a hero. Didn't that make it happen? As soon as he lose, people try to act like, oh, it's a big thing. Oh, it ain't. I lost to a dude way bigger than me. Big deal. Right? But he's trying to do something. It's guys like that that I just consider to be above the rest. They try to do something. Guillermo Rigondeaux. Beat Donaire, got blackballed, tried to fight everybody, had two or three divisions running away from him. They won't let him fight. You're going to see when I tell you, when Inoue beats Donaire, then 4 years later now, next week, watch what they do to Inoue. He's going to be the biggest thing in boxing. They won't do that. They didn't do that to Rigondeaux, but Rigondeaux is what you call a hero. Deontay Wilder was the same way. Hey, he wants to be undisputed. We saw him trying to become undisputed with Anthony Joshua. And Anthony Joshua didn't want it. And people argued at you for years. And there's the other big old dude didn't want to have it. Right now, he still would try to become undisputed if Andy Ruiz Jr. beats Joshua because Joshua would be in the way. Joshua wouldn't do it. But Andy Ruiz might. Deontay wants to be undisputed. Here's another example of why people like Deontay Wilder. People like fairness. Right? Just fairness. That's what this is all about. It's just somebody fair. Someone wants to be one champion. That's what you want to hear. You know, because people like that are people that are not just boxing fans, because some people that are just boxing fans are used to just being duped all the time. And they like people and they don't want one champion in all these divisions that we have and all these champions. They don't want it. That's why they're always mad at you when you're asking for one champion. Like you're the crazy one, right? Well, we've been all upset about this franchise title. That franchise now. All these titles we got. Somebody had the nerve to make the franchise WBC because they wanted to give it to Canelo so he don't have to fight Charlo. He don't have to fight Charlo. In a fight that's bigger than all these other fights Canelo's having, he can fight Charlo in Texas. Charlo is a twin brother that's been champion in two weight divisions. So he don't have to fight him. We make a new belt that doesn't have to fight mandatories. And we give it to him. And then we give one to Lomachenko, right? Lomachenko fought one time for the WBC, and he got a franchise belt, which means they don't have to fight the mandatories. And coincidentally, the mandatories are hard, like Charlo or Devin Haney, guys that we know are formidable, right? So people have been speculating that they might give it to Deontay Wilder, which, you know, people are like, you better, because Deontay Wilder's been longer at WBC than both of these guys. Canelo Alvarez wanted to throw your belt away when you forced him to fight Gennady Golovkin. Canelo said, no, and I don't want nothing to do with the WBC. Soleiman, who's Mexican, said, well, we better leave that boy alone next time he gets the WBC. And that's what they're doing, right? That's what they're doing, leaving him alone. So he don't have to fight no mandatories, and he can go up and fight Kovalev instead of fighting mandatories or an undisputed fight, stuff like that. But Deontay Wilder's come out and said, I don't want that damn belt. I'm paraphrasing. I don't want that. He said he's heard about the belt. People ask him about the belt. But he says he's listened to his fans and his heart. He says, and I'm paraphrasing. I could read it, but I ain't read it. I'm a paraphrase because, you know, you already got it. Bottom line is, why would I want a belt that makes me not fight my mandatories? I like mandatories. I'm trying to become undisputed so we can have undisputed, and then all I would fight was mandatories. Why would we want to take something away from someone who has worked their way up in the rankings to become mandatory challenger, especially if it's done correctly and nobody was cheating? He become mandatory, and now we deprive him of fighting the champion. Why would I want to be a part of that? That's what Deontay Wilder does. Now, what would your favorite fighter do? He probably would take it. Now, my advice to all fighters is follow suit. Follow Deontay Wilder. Because what happens is it takes fans a long time. But people who are evil and hateful, they won't like this because they want to be able to say this guy and that guy's better without someone proving it. But follow Deontay Wilder's what he's up to. Don't take no franchise. Don't want it. Talk smack about the franchise championship, because what you can do, you can embarrass these fools that took it. Why the hell Loma asked for it, matter of fact. You know what I mean? People just like Jerry Golovkin's asked for Samaretta to become mandatory so he can fight a guy with four knockouts or five knockouts. All these shenanigans that are going on, right? There's a lot of shenanigans that's going on. So I'm just saying that. You can make your you can make the people who took it have their reputations in tatters for wanting a belt that you won't have to fight mandatories. Who wants that? A real champion does it, and Deontay Wilder is a real champion. That's why we like him, guys, right? We don't care that his hands is windmilling or whatever. We know he's in the gym. He hasn't been doped. He hasn't, you know, he's fighting anybody. He wants to fight anybody. And everybody still says it's like he's protected. Deontay, I mean, you know something? People that say that are probably not people, guys. These are somebody that's just, you know, a chaos theory. People that are coming in with chaos just to say stupid things in comment section. No one in their right mind still believes Deontay is not trying to fight somebody, especially no damn Anthony Joshua. But anybody else either. Dillian White. When he gave Dillian White a chance, Dillian White should have fought Ortiz. They was ordered. He said no. Then Deontay Wilder said, well, forget what's ordered, man. You fight Ortiz. You beat Ortiz. I don't care where you ranked. I got you right after that. Dillian White didn't even do that. This dude is trying to fight whoever to become undisputed. Right? So I'm ranting. So while I'm in a rant video and giving props to Deontay Wilder video, which people are going thumbs down and don't want to see anyway because talking about Deontay Wilder, what the hell with y'all? You know what I'm saying? Because this is what we want. This is how a fighter should act, right? But while I'm at it, you know, I was just thinking the other day, it was really, man, somebody come in here, man, help me out. Because boxing is getting so bad. You know how I think of boxing. It's BTBG. BTBG. That's what I think about boxing for the last couple of years. It's been that way. And BTBG, I asked people and nobody came up. One guy came up with close with it, but it's beat the black guy. That's all boxing is in America. It really is. And I'm just was thinking is when you're looking at rematches, just to prove my point, and somebody please come in with me and help me out so I'm not right about this. There's got to be a couple of instances that I just can't remember. But I don't remember a black guy losing a close fight and then there was outrage for him to get a rematch. You understand what I'm saying? Like, it was a close fight, and the black guy lost. And then, to a non-black fighter, of course, right? He lost to a non-black fighter, right? And there was outrage in America for him to get a rematch. I can't remember that, right? I just can't. Now, you remember Ndam lost, they cheated and gave Ndam a middleweight, a decision against the Japanese guy, Murata. He had to fight Murata again right away, didn't he? Now, you remember Tim Bradley beat Pacquiao in the first fight with two bad wheels. Both his ankles sprung. Gets a close nod against Pacquiao, was outraged. He even got death threats. So much so that he went in there the next fight and fought like a fool against Provotnikov. Almost lost his mind in there, literally. Right? He got death threats. It was, you know, he had to fight him again. But when a black guy like Ward got a close fight against Kovalev, didn't he have to fight Kovalev right away? You know what I'm saying? But when Jacobs, you know, was close against Gennady Golovkin, Gennady Golovkin doesn't have to readdress that. When Canelo was close against Jacobs, Canelo don't have to readdress Jacobs, even though it was close. Canelo don't have to readdress Lara, even though it was close. Canelo don't have to readdress Trout, even though that was open scoring. Right? Doesn't. Now, another brother got cheated the other day. Contadagua. That brother who fought Demetrius Andrade on short notice at 160 pounds, knew about 8 days, and was able to get down to 160 pounds, Kuntadawa, he went somewhere to Kazakhstan and got cheated. I haven't seen the fight yet. Word has it he got cheated royally. There's not going to be an outcry for Kuntadawa to get another shot, right? So I don't know when there's never been, where a black guy gets a decision or doesn't get the decision and we say, hey, he's got to get another rematch. Guys, help me out, please, because right now I can't think of any. Now I can think of an instance where in heavyweight, remember where George Foreman beat Axel Schultz, and Axel Schultz really outpointed him. They thought, he didn't get a rematch. Normally they would got a rematch, but he didn't. Other than that, I can't come up with anything. And I would like to, just to be, so there's a little fairness, but that just shows you I can't. And you guys know one damn thing, whether you like me or not, whether I'm loud enough, whether my microphone's on, whether you can see me good with all the pixels that you need and all that old stuff that people act like they need, right? One thing you know is that brother knows about sport. And he obviously been watching it more than a couple of decades, right? And if I can't remember, but I don't have a good memory, I'm going to tell you that. But I can't remember where there was outrage for a brother to get a rematch. Please help me out with that. But back to the top. Deontay Wilder says, stick that damn franchise title somewhere, right? Stick it somewhere. Because I'm not rolling like that. And I'm not treating mandatories that worked hard to get up there and not giving them opportunities to fight me, the real champ. What do you think about that? Doma Sports Talk. Worldwide. Thanks, Deontay Wilder. And I'm up out of here.